first ever running in the Olympic Games of the 3,000 metres for women. 7.5 laps of the track.
On your marks.
Way quite smoothly. Mary Decker's the first to show. Koichi on the inside. The big two right up there straight away. 3-2-4 is Berkey of Switzerland. The outside, number 300, Kuna of Portugal. So as they settle down, Mary Decker, who doesn't mind front running at all, is there. Koichi in second place. Possume of Italy is third. Zola Budd comes up on the outside. They've got 7 laps to go now. I've got a feeling, actually, if Mary Decker takes the first 3 or 4 laps, they will see Zola Budd try to go on in front and do some front running herself. Because I did feel the other night, and she probably realised it, and her coach as well, that she lacked a change of pace at the finish. She tends to lengthen her stride when she's going to the finish rather than shorten and then quicken and then really accelerate away. A change of pace may be a bit suspect, and I think she may well go up front after about 3-4 laps. An added advantage for her today is that Labuschagne, her coach, who couldn't get onto the warm-up track because he hadn't got the right pass during the qualifying 2 nights ago, he's been able to join her today, and that would have steadied her down considerably. The first lap, quite quick, is almost on world record pace at 67 seconds.
Well, I'm not surprised to see Mary Decker at the front here, because I think she considers Puicea from Romania as her main rival. And Puicea had a run yesterday in the 1500 metres to qualify for tomorrow's 1500 metres final. So Mary thinks that the fact that Puicea's had that extra race, and if she extends the pace today, it'll put some more pressure on Puicea for the later stages. And I think that's a sensible decision, because Mary is not going to want to give it away for lack of trying. She's determined to win a gold medal. She's very confident she can win a gold medal. And I think she's giving herself the best chance by extending the pace here. She's used to running at the front. She always runs at the front in America. And she's no stranger to this position. And right on her shoulder there, Zola Budd. In fact, Zola Budd's got a big picture of Mary Decker in her bedroom wall, and she says she's my heroine, she's my star. And to find herself here in the Olympic Games, I think a few months ago, Zola would never have dreamed of this possible.
My word, they are moving along, 67-68. They're inside a 13:30 schedule, which is very fast indeed. The world record, 8:30 schedule rather, the world record is 8:26.78 from Marsova of the Soviet Union. I wouldn't say it's under threat in these conditions, because it's still very warm in this stadium. Half of it in shadow, half still bathed in sunshine. But having said that, we've got the world champion in front. And the world junior record holder in second place. The international cross-country champion is third. Wendy Sly goes into fourth place. Possumé is 5. Joan Hansen, or rather Joan Hansen, who's 26 in fact, who's third in the American trials, is in sixth place. Seventh is like Lynn Williams of Canada, or Berkey of Switzerland. No, Lynn Williams is just in front of her in seventh place. Berkey is eighth. The tall West German, Brigitte Krauss, in ninth place. Coming round now to complete 3 laps. There's no better judge of pace than Mary Decker. And Zola Budd really has been taken along into unknown areas for her pace-wise. 8:37 is Zola's best time. Mary Decker's best time, 8:29. And it's slowed to a 69 there, so they're right on schedule at the moment, or just over an 8:30 schedule.
Well, I'm sure Wendy Sly is being spurred on there by seeing Zola Budd ahead of her, because Wendy's pretty determined to prove herself as Britain's number one 3,000 metre runner, and she sees little Zola there ahead of her, and I think that prompted her to action. But I think Zola's done very well so far to just sit in that position on the outside. She sees the 4 lap counter up, and she's probably starting to think that she may have a go, and both her and Wendy Sly are having a go, but Mary Decker wasn't going to have any of it. She's quite happy at the front and on the inside.
Somebody fell there, and I think it was Joan Hansen while you were talking, Brendan, who's third in the American trials, and she's right at the back. The two British girls are putting pressure on there. Zola Budd tracked by Wendy Sly, and Wendy Sly went up outside Zola Budd just for a moment, as she's doing again, just threatening the little girl who seems to be dwarfed there. They call her the little bird. That wide elbow action and arm action, though, she's not easy to get round. And she's having a good go for the lead, as I thought she might. That was the 72nd lap. So after four laps, as I thought she might, she's having a go at taking the lead. Barefooted, she's much happier barefooted. And the world champion, oh, caught her there. Now this is the danger. And Decker's down. Oh, the world champion and one of the favourites is now flat out on the infield. And Mary Decker out of the race. And little Zola Budd may have clipped in too soon. May not have been her fault, but certainly she seemed twice there to impede Mary Decker. And the booing has started around the arena. Well, this little girl's career seems to be followed by nothing but controversies and drama as well. The golden girl of American distance running, reduced now to not even watching the race, but lying there in pain. Two British girls, the first three, Puicha with them, and they're a long way clear of the rest.
That was a remarkable piece of concentration, because Zola definitely did get tied up in that tangle with Mary Decker, and for them to positively respond like this and to go to the front and start pushing the pace along, it shows remarkable attitude for a young girl of her age. But threatening there behind them in third place is Puicha, the Romanian, who we've been worried about all the way along the line, but it looks to me two Britons for two medals, but the threat is still there, the blonde-haired Romanian looking strong. And when she sees the two lap scorer in a, which they're approaching now, I'm sure she'll get a boost of confidence. But it's a great run by Wendy and Zola Budd.
Well, the Americans don't know whether to boo or applaud in this audience. Some are booing, some are applauding. It's a sad sight to see Mary Decker there on the ground, because she's contributed so much to world athletics. We've seen her in Britain, of course, many times, and all around the world. Very, very popular figure. And she looks as if she may, well, be quite seriously hurt. There's quite a group around her. Surprising, actually, but Zola Budd didn't get spiked there. And the race really on now for gold, silver and bronze. And we've got two Britons in it. It's a lap and a half left. It's Wendy Sly in front. And Veruni Peter Kraus is out of the race as well. Another of the favourites. And this is astonishing. They're passing the stricken Mary Decker now. And Zola Budd's in trouble, she's tiring, and Wendy Sly is the great threat. 8:37 is the British record, by the way, and it's Wendy Sly against Puicha. 7:30 at the bell. Puicha was great distance runner from Romania, Wendy Sly back after injury, and Zola Budd being caught for third place. Weicher up on the outside with 2:50 to go. Great Britain versus Romania. And Zola Budd is being caught for the bronze medal. She's failing rapidly. And Weicher goes. The yellow vest of Romania showing in front. Wendy Sly hanging on, though. 5 metre gap. And Zola Budd will not get the bronze medal. She's now back in sixth place, completely spent. This gold is for Romania. Mary Decker, what must her feelings be as she sees her go by? Wendy Sly in second place will take the silver. Puicha wins the first ever 3,000 metres, 8:35.98. In second place, silver for Great Britain, Wendy Sly. And place, it looked to me like Lynn Williams of Canada, with Zola Budd sixth or seventh. The early pace, total. Zola Budd on the last lap,